Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel, and for today's video we will show to you how we enjoy our journey in homeschooling. I will be with Tasha and I will be checking her preparation for the second quarter. I hope you enjoy and like it.
Make your voice louder.
So I wrote a personal narrative. So first, what is a personal narrative essay? Personal narrative essay is about personal experience and it's usually written in the first person. So yes, sir. My personal essay is entitled Mashed Potato Pizza.
What's the title?
Mashed Potato Pizza.
Okay.
When I was 7, my grandpa always told me that people who laugh at their own mistakes will get everyone else to laugh along with them. Yesterday, I learned that she was right.
That?
He was right.
Okay.
Stay in line, like Auntie Lady said. I knew right away that my friend Kate wouldn't be able to be with me in line. So I decided to just buy a piece of her too. Soon, the line began to move faster, and I followed along hoping that there would still be two pizzas for me and my friend. When I reached the counter, I looked at the choices. I could only see chicken and mashed potatoes, macaroni and cheese, and fish. I could hear the rumble of my nervous pointed stomach. Then out of the corner of my eye, I saw one last piece of pepperoni pizza, and I got so excited. Pepperoni pizza, I said politely. The canteen lady handed me the pizza. I took a paper plate so quickly that the pizza slid off the plate. I tried to save it, but the pizza landed in a bag of hot, watery mashed potatoes. I could feel my face turning redder and redder. All I could hear was laughter and the kids in line. As I looked at the upside down pizza, I heard the canteen lady's voice. Would you like a side of mashed potatoes with your pizza? I looked up and many people are looking at me. With a nervous smile, I replied, of course, at the canteen lady. The canteen lady smiled and scooped the mashed potato pizza on the plate. I looked around at the canteen and we all laughed again. I never really believed my grandpa until I saw my schoolmates laughing at me. The laughing made me feel good instead of me to feel sad about having to make a pepperoni pizza. That's all.
Okay, so what's the lesson of that personal essay?
I learned how to write a personal narrative, and this story happened when I was 7 with my grandpa when I was still studying in the Philippines.
Okay, so what was the lesson learned?
I learned that he was right, that when you laugh at your own mistakes, you will get everyone else to laugh along with you.
Okay, that is normal to commit mistakes, but what is important is
you learn from it.
You learn from it, and you have to learn from each and every experience, from your personal experience, from the experiences of your friends or of the other people that around. And what is important is that you are not repeating the same mistake. Okay, very good. So in here, I have encoded as part of your recitation, recited her personal essay entitled Mashed Potato. Is this correct?
Personal narrative.
Personal narrative. Okay, let's continue. Let's have a review of the 8 parts of speech. What are the 8 parts of speech?
Okay, so the 8 parts of speeches. Number 1, noun. Noun means a person, thing, places, or idea.
Without reading, you have to tell me what have you learned? What is saved in your memory about the parts of speeches?
Okay, so number 1, noun. Noun names a person, place, thing, or idea. For example, Tasha, which is my name, Greece, a dream country, and success is an idea. Number 2, pronoun. Pronoun replaces a name of a person, place, thing, or idea.
Or pronoun replaces the noun.
Yeah.
Right.
Example, she, he, itself, himself, herself.
It,
and more.
Okay.
Number 3, verb. Verb describes some experience or an action. I mean, short
verb is an action word.
For example, singing, which is my passion, dancing, that's run, jump, hop, many more. Number 4, adverb. Adverb is a word that modifies an adjective, verb, and another adverb. Here's an example sentence. She swims quickly. The adverb quickly modifies the verb swims. Number 5 is adjective. An adjective describes a noun or a pronoun. Adjective is a describing word.
Give us an example.
Example is beautiful.
Make it in a sentence.
Beautiful. My mom is beautiful.
Okay.
then color, and then color black, tone, taste, bitter, sour.
Next.
Number six, preposition. It is used before a noun or pronoun. It is used before a noun or pronoun to show place, time, and direction.
Example,
at, in, on, about, to, for, from.
Use it in a sentence.
I got this laptop from my mom, and the preposition that I used is from.
Okay.
Number seven, conjunction. Conjunction join words or a group of words in a sentence. For example, and, yet, so, because, until, moreover, and so on.
Give us an example sentence.
It was too early, yet we were ready to go for bed because of the long night.
Okay.
Number eight, interjection. Interjection expresses a strong feeling. It is often followed by an exclamation point.
For example,
hooray! I will be spending my two holidays in the beach.
Okay, but for this quarter, we shall be focusing more of adverbs and prepositions, okay? So can you tell me what is your understanding about interrogative adverbs and adverbial nouns? Okay, let's check one activity. Open your book and go to exercise number 3. 6.2, interrogative adverbs and adverbial nouns. Exercise number 3.
Okay.
This activity is filling the blanks.
Number one. How did you travel on your last vacation?
First, you have to read like this. Blank, did you travel last vacation? Right?
Okay.
Then you have to read again by mentioning your answer. Start.
Okay. Exercise 3. Blank, did you travel on your last vacation? Answer. How did you travel on your last vacation?
Very good.
Number 2. Blank, did you go? Answer. Where did you go?
Next.
Number 3. We traveled approximately blank. Answer. We traveled approximately 1,000 miles.
Good.
Number 4. The trip took 5 hours.
The trip took blank.
Blank. Answer. The trip took 5 hours. Number 5. Blank, did you choose to visit a theme park? Answer. Why did you choose to visit a theme park?
Say it again, number 5.
Why did you choose to visit a theme
Chose.
Park?
Say it again.
Why did you choose to visit a theme park?
Read a blank, number 5.
Blank, did you choose to visit a theme park? Answer. Why did you choose to visit a theme park?
Good. For the performance task of this subject. What is your preparation for the performance task? Are you ready with the performance task? Okay, how many performance tasks have you prepared? As per our book, you have to prepare what makes a good personal narrative. Okay, that one is correct. The mashed potato. Then you have your to-do list is how-to articles, business letters. Okay, we will now start to write business letters. What makes a good business letter? Purpose and tone. Using adjective and adverb clauses. Okay, this is your to-do list. You have to read chapter 3 of the second part, written and oral communication. Write something on your notes.
This is actually third and fourth quarter.
Hmm?
This is third and fourth quarter.
The second part?
Yes. The written and oral communication from chapter 1 to chapter 5, third and fourth.
So we have to complete this.
Part 1 grammar, section 1 through section 11 is for first and third.
Okay, but what I am saying is, when you go through part two, okay, when you start preparing this, then you can go back to the references of the verbals, of those adverbs, or the parts of the speeches, including punctuation, capitalization, diagramming, conjunctions, and interjections, then it will be easier for you. With the English subject. Is conjunction still part of the second quarter? Wait, dito magpapaksa. Okay, for the performance task of this subject, what is your preparation for the performance task? Are you ready with the performance task? Okay, how many performance tasks can you prepare? As per our book, you have to prepare what makes a good personal narrative. Okay, that one is correct, the mashed potato. Then we have okay, your to-do list is how to articles, business letters. Okay, we will now start to write business letters. What makes a good business letter? Purpose and tone. using adjective and adverb clauses. Okay, this is your to-do list. You have to read chapter 3 of the second part, written and oral communication.